You men argue that the Great Star Mining Company is illegally in possession of your property. Now, that's on the basis of miners' law. A local agreement among miners who prospected here before the war.
Who's got a better right to make miners' laws than the men that found the gold in the first place? That's us.
That's right.
We've heard your testimony, Corporal. Are there any other witnesses?
Yes, sir, me.
All right, Johnny.
My brother Jericho and me had a claim before the war. A good claim that we found and staked out according to miners' law. Right spang in the middle of what Ed Carter claims is his now. Well, I mean to dig that claim.
Good boy.
Man's got a right to keep what he found.
We've heard one side of the case, now let's hear the other. Mr. Carter.
Why, yes, Owen. Being your honor, Colorado is now a federal territory. Someday, and someday soon, Colorado is going to add another bright star to that glorious flag.
Let's get to the point.
All right, Judge. I'll get to the point. Miners' law went out when federal law came in. The United States government says a man who doesn't work his claim at all in any three-year period loses all rights to that claim.
The judge knows where we've been the last 3 years. He was there with us.
Yes, I know where you've been, too. But you men can't live on the war the rest of your life.
We don't want to. We want what belonged to us before the war and still does.
But it doesn't. And no man here can say that I haven't acted in absolute strict accordance with federal law.
Law. Law, that's all we hear.
And it's all your law, Mr. Carter. All for you and none for us.
You know as well as we do, Judge, the only gold around here is up on Yellow Mountain. Why should he have all of it?
Yeah, that's right.
Your Honor, I'd like to get something off my chest.
All right, go ahead.
I can't argue law, and I won't try to. But fact is fact. These men came to Colorado to pan a fortune the same as Mr. Carter. They had property when they left, and now they're being told that they lost what they had while fighting for their country. They can't make a living if their claims are taken away from them.
Why, I'll hire every man honorably discharged from the regiment and glad to do it.
Hooray! Hire us to work our own claim!
I'll pay top wages, $60 a month, cash on the barrelhead.
A man can't live on that, and you know he can't.
You come work for me, Ed. I'll pay you $65 a month and throw in a pair of shoes every other Christmas.
Let's have order. I'm in a peculiar position here. My sympathy and personal feelings are the same as the marshal's. I know what you men are up against. But my personal feelings can't enter into my decision as a federal judge. Now, if I ruled in your favor, my decision would be reversed by a court of appeals. Now, if there's injustice in the law, that's a matter for Congress in Washington, not for this court. In accordance with the law, the lands here in dispute, whose claimants did no work on them within the 3 years immediately preceding the date of this action, are public lands and subject to preemption. Therefore, I am compelled to rule that the defendant in this action, the Great Star Mining Company, is legally the owner of the lands preempted. I'll have to make it a part of the record here that anyone found trespassing on the Great Star Mining Company's property after this date does so in defiance of the law and at his own risk. Court is adjourned.